action is back. What do you know? Since my opponent lost, he gets to choose whether or not he wants to go first. Do I want to keep this hand? I have no plays. Well, that's not entirely true. I do have a 1/3. I will eventually get to do a Sky Spawner, but I have like three... I have two big freaking cards in my hand. I'll keep it. I don't know. I don't really like this hand. This is a pretty good opportunity for my opponent to do something dirty. Exactly the same play as before that he did. In case you forgot what this does. I will also show you what my guys do. Again, I'll keep saying it. Be ready with that pause button when you see a card you don't understand or you don't know what's up with. What be good do thing happen. I am recording, right? Oh, I am. Oh, yeah. Oh, good, an anticipate. That's actually really good. Because that will grab me another land if I need one. Which I do. Which I do if I miss my land drop. Which I already have. Let's see. He is a 1/1. So he is trying to do the life gain drain deck. I'm going to put the Felidar Cub out over the Stonehaven Mystic. And I'm doing that in case he has some kind of pump spell, but as I say that, I think the Stonehaven... Well, I keep saying Mystic. The Stonehaven Medic is a better play. And I did miss it. I totally, 100% missed my land drop. That is why I'm going to do this right now. Instantaneous main phase switcheroo. Losing a sheer drop, losing a courier griffin, grabbing that plains. Gotta get it. And since I need to be aggressive right now, I'm just going to go ahead and swing. It is possible that he can gain two life. He's going to hit me for one. That's happening. Because he doesn't want to lose that creature. Is this another ally or another creature? Another creature. Damn, that's a good card. Shit, man. Huh. Wow. So imagine having a whole bunch of freaking those Eldrazi spawners that things like this come out with. Whoop. Sorry about that. That's all me. Another one of these, not bad. I think I'd rather have the Eldrazi Sky Spawner because I am missing land drops now. And this will shit out a little token that helps me gain life. Mana. So if I wanted to put down a 4-drop, which I don't at the moment. Oh shit, counter? Nope. Natural connection. Instant speed. So he's getting all of his land drops. Super sucky. Super sucky trucky. I don't really need 4 lands or 4 mana, do I? I don't really have anything. The only thing that I really have is the Inspired Charge. And I don't even have a 5-drop other than this guy, which actually I might do. No, I wouldn't. Not if I only have 3 lands. This is something if I have 5 lands out. Yeah, I'm not gonna... I think I would just rather save this as either an attacker or a blocker. So I think next turn I'm just swinging all in for a 5. And if he wants to stop it, I guess he can block the Felidar Club, or if he wants to trade with the Scion, that'd be fine with me too. Not sure what he's planning here. He's got a lot of land. A lot more than me. I've been missing drops. But it's really my own fault. That is a waste of a great card. You don't have anywhere near enough shit for that to be relevant, dude. You're gonna swing in for 3? That, go ahead. Dude, that's terrible. This card wins games, guys. Don't just drop it for a quick two extra damage. He only has one land open, so I don't think he's got any other plays. Ugh, what a waste. God, what a waste. I feel terrible. I feel icky. Holy shit. +2/+1. So this is what I could do, and I might actually do it. I could swing in with everything, and then his War Caller is going to block my Felidar Club. Then I can drop my Inspired Charge. My War Caller will win, and I will hit him for an additional 4 on top of the 3. So I'll put him to 9, if I wanted to do that. My other option is just to drop my McKindy Patrol, which is actually, in my opinion, a better play. So that's what I'm going to do. And I'm going to do it now, pre-combat, because it has Rally, and it will give my other guys Vigilance. They will remain vigilant. And I will swing, and even swing with the Scion. If he wants to block it, I will be totally happy to trade. Fuck it. I'll swing with everything. I guess it's not a total waste. If he has more allies, he can really smack me around. But I don't know if he has any more. I mean, I saw him do the life gain thing, and last game I didn't really see him that ally heavy, so I feel like that's only going to be like an every now and then thing. I don't have anything that costs 5 that I'd really give a shit about. I guess Rush of Ice, and then I can get a 3-3 out with haste. Would that be game? Not quite. I need one more damage for that to be game. Actually, no, it definitely won't be game because I'm counting this guy, so I need 2 more damage. So this would increase my damage by 2, not 3. Eh. Not really that useful right now. I need 6. I need 6 lands, and I've been behind in lands. There's a thing that I'm worried about. Whenever it comes into play, other creatures get 1. If it's a swamp, it gets +2. Nice. Very nice. And it is a flyer. Alright, actually, Rush of Ice looks like a much more legitimate card now. On the other hand... Ooh, Kozilek's Channeler. Wow. Wow. That's a great card to see, too. Can I wipe his field? I can wipe his field. And he won't be able to wipe mine. This will probably block the Sky Spawner, which I'm okay with. On the other hand, I can just drop Kozilek's Channeler. I think I'm more comfortable doing that, because this will ramp me for next turn, although I can't win next turn. Nope, I'm not comfortable doing that. I want to do the Inspired Charge, actually. Maybe I can wipe his board this way. That's exactly what I'm going to do. That is exactly what I'll do to you. This is a greedy play, you guys. But he has to block, otherwise he loses. Yeah, he has to block. Is that game? That could be game. Yup. You should have blocked, man. Should have blocked. Oh, well. Poor guy. Oh, man. That was fun. All right, guys. I will see you in the next round. Well, actually, first, I wanted to show you. I won 2-0. So, as you can see here, the first one I got in 13 minutes, the second one I got in 9 minutes. And since that is best 2 out of 3... Bada bing, bada boom, you know? Like, that's how it is. Now, rounds last maximum 50 minutes. So at 50-minute mark, whoever's... I think they either get five turns left each, or they just shut off as a draw, or... I don't remember exactly what happened. Something along those lines happened. Actually, I think they just automatically lose. Whoever loses the timer loses. Whatever. I'm sorry. So we're in blue because we're the first ones who finished our match. That means our game is over. We are playing Swiss match, so he will be able to continue playing. And I want a pack, actually, because we are in, as you can see up here, pack per win. So the next time I want to play, remember, I need 3 packs. I just cut my costs down by a little bit less than a third. Unless I sell every of the contents of all the packs that I got, which they're not really going to be worth that much, but I will do it anyway. That'll increase the winnings that I got, if that makes any sense. I know it's kind of complicated right now. Sorry. End result: you can, if you're very good, actually make money off of MTGO, and you do drafting or even tournaments or anything. You just, you know, get your ass over here and play the hell out of it. Get really good, win tournaments all the time. And specifically in drafts, you can sell the cards you draft. Even in constructed, you can win money. A little more difficult to win money there, but if you're decent, you can win back the money that you pay to get into the tournament. If you're good, you can actually get money out of the game, which is super cool. The money is in the form of tickets, which you can sell to third parties for around the vicinity of, let's say, 90 cents to the dollar. So you're losing about 10%, but I mean, in paper magic, you're probably losing upwards of 15% just from transaction costs. Like, you go to a draft and you buy a bunch of product and you want to resell that product. You know, doing it on TCG Trader or eBay or, hell, even Puka Trade, I mean, you still have costs associated with selling those 50-cent cards, you know, and those are the majority of the cards that you're going to be grabbing or even trying to sell. So here, you don't have any of that. The maximum transaction fee is, like, what, 10%-ish? Maybe even a little bit less than that. Maybe it's more like 9%. So the possibility of making money exists here. Very few. Like, I'm talking less than 1% of the players do it. And even the pros, they generally only have, like, a 60-ish percent win rate. So you have to be pretty damn good in order to make this happen. It probably won't happen, so I'm actually not, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm, like, talking something up that probably will not be relevant for you guys. By the way, I didn't just miss it. These two guys finished their game recently. This guy, Rupture, won 2-0. He won both matches. So we're probably going to get matched up with him next round, because there is a matchmaking system here, and since we both won the same way, we will be up against each other, probably, unless someone else gets 2-0, but I don't think so. There's only 2 more games running on right now. Anyway, I'm sorry. I'm rambling, explaining shit. Honestly, the best way to teach you, if you guys have questions, just hit me up in the comments. I will absolutely, I always do this. I will always answer your questions and shit, so just hit me with that. I will answer them. I'll try to be as impartial as possible. Again, In terms of saving money, I think duels is probably your best way to go. It also looks a lot nicer, in my opinion, in most people's opinion. MTGO is a little bit more hardcore. It looks like it was written in the 80s. It probably was. And although there's a lot of potential, I mean, God, you can say that about duels anyway. You know what? Fuck it. Guys, look, if you have questions, ask me. I will hit you the answer. Up until then, Let's go to the next match. Like right now. This is completely unkeepable. Half to mulligan. That is absolutely keepable. I've got 4 lands. That is a few too many lands, so I want to put that in the bottom. that's a little too much. He obviously wants to go first, because I feel like he's a little more aggressive than I am. Good game from him, by the way. He played very well. I got a little... I don't want to say I got a better deck than him. He has a lot more synergy, and he can shit out a lot of scary things. That tells me that that's his only black source, so that's why he did that immediately. Looks like this is going to be similar to last game so far. Gonna get this coming down right now. Stonehaven Medic. Good card, in case you guys forgot what these guys do. I mean, I keep forgetting to do this. That's fine. Looks like he's got no plays, which is great for me. Swinging for 1. Put him to 19. Obviously, I don't think he's too worried about that. I actually have an option here, McKindy Patrol over Eldrazi Sky Spawner, but I think I want the Sky Spawner out because I feel he's going to have a creature that's coming down somewhat soon. By the way, I also feel like he had... Oh, shit. There it is. I still get the token, yeah. But, damn, man. He must have grabbed all those freaking complete disregards, man. I mean, I can't believe how freaking great he's been with those. Just on time, each time. Thankfully, I have my own my own nuisance card. Whoops. No, you're going in there. That was a mistake. You're getting in there. Drop a land. I got four, but this is still the play. And let's see if he can deal with that. So far, it looks like a no, which is great for me. He must have just drawn that swamp, otherwise I don't think he would have played that earlier. Okay, looks like... I'm just going to pass priority completely. Pass priority, by the way, you hit F6 and... Oh, shit! That's a great card, man. 4-3 flyer. Oh, wow. Wow. How did he kill my creature? He exiled them. He complete disregarded it. Wow. Well, not a whole lot I can do about that. I have 5, so I'm going to dump... Why did I do that? Oh, God. I could have played them both. Son of a bitch. Yeah, I'm not swinging with anything. God damn it. I tapped all 3 white mana for this fucking guy. Like a complete bitch. like a total bitch. Problem with this guy. He's going to come in here. He's going to smack me real hard in the air. Nothing I can do about it. And he's going to get the scry too. It's just one hell of a card. Great, great card. Super good. It's going to die. Has to die. In fact, I can even sacrifice... Ooh, and that's just what I'm going to do. Unless he has another blocking creature. What I'm saying is, in order to cast the 6, I'm gonna kill 2 of these guys to keep one of my planes untapped so I can swing with it the same turn. Unless he has another blocker for me here, in which case I won't do that. He does have another blocker. It's not a big blocker. Okay, I'll do that anyway then. It's not as bad as I thought it was, so I'll definitely do that. Pass turn. Ooh, there's a nice card too. And I don't have the mana for it. Shit. Shit, shit, shit. Huh. Now I gotta think about this. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I kill this guy. I tap. I can put out a tapped planes if I wanted to. Or I can sack them both out. No, that's what's going to happen here. I already have 2 cards in exile, so I don't care about this ingest. He's already got his exile triggers. I'm going to swing and a swing. See what you can do with that. Oh, he is blocking. Okay. Well, I mean, I guess it doesn't really matter. I assumed he would think that I have a combat trick or something, but he didn't put me on it, so that's fine. I'm playing with the idea of dropping my 3/4, but I'm totally wrong. This Windrider has to die. Cast with Awaken, kill that guy. Choose a land I control. Boom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then sacrifice an Eldrazi. Put that out there. Next turn, I'm going to sacrifice the next Eldrazi to put down my Wavewing. Which will actually I might not do. No, I will do that. Who am I kidding? Yeah, I'm going to do that. That's exactly what I'm going to do. Oh, shit. All right, so what is this? I bring a creature back. No. I exile a creature. He puts... Okay, all right. So he draws a card. That goes into exile, which kind of sucks for me, but I can't bring it back. Oh, that's what he's worried about. He thinks next turn I'm going to have that Halimar Tidecaller or whatever thing is and put it back in my hand, and he doesn't want me to do that again. I don't blame him. But only if he has another bomb, which I don't think he has the mana. Well, he might, actually. Yeah, he could have the bomb. He's got three cards in hand. One of them is probably, you know, a big cost creature. He's got seven mana potential. Six from lands, one from the Scion. Let's see what he does here. If he taps everything down, complete disregard on my land, that sucks. That really fucking sucks. Big deal for me. I really need these fucking lands. Damn it, man. Shit. These fucking complete disregards that this guy got. My god, dude. Fucking swimming in those things. All right. Well, nothing I can do, so I'll just pass priority. Let's see if he swings. He does swing, so he's got other plays. I'm assuming. I don't know. He's not doing bad. He's doing real damn good right now. Oh, God, that shits me. Oh, thank God. Thank God. Okay, so that's five. Sacrifice the Eldrazi for six. Then I can put this guy down. Let's swing first. Let's see what he does with this. I assume he's only going to take one here. Nope. He takes it all. Okay, that's fine. He's wondering what I have. That's what's going on. If he has another complete disregard, I'm going to be pissed off right now. I'm going to be so mad at him, man. It's like, how do you keep getting these damn things, man? How many did you fucking rip? Of course, you know what? What I have noticed in Battle for Zendikar, black is perceived to be a somewhat weak color, and I can understand that. I can get behind that. He got his own incubator drone. Shits out another Eldrazi token. So if black kept going around the table and nobody picked from it, I mean, I don't even know if I looked at black, honestly. And there it is. No, it wasn't. It wasn't a complete disregard. It was bone splinters on one of his Eldrazi. Nice, very nice, dude. Not sure if I can do a whole lot with this. I'm in a lot of trouble right now. I mean, we're both down to one card. A 2-3. Another 2-3. Yeah, I'm gonna put it on this guy. Then I'm gonna swing in. What's the point of swinging in with this? I could just gain a life from it next turn. He either blocks this or he doesn't. And he's not gonna block the one. No, screw that. I'm just gonna do this way. And then I can gain a life from it later. He takes the damage. I show him that I have nothing left. This sucks. This fucking sucks. I'm in a lot of trouble, you guys. I'm in a lot of trouble right now. This is not... I mean, he fucking got me real good right now. What I need is a bomb of some kind. I need something. Something more than I'm getting. I mean, he's only pinging me for one, but I know he's got massive things in his hand. Or not necessarily in his hand. It looks like he doesn't have much in his hand, actually. Come on, pass turn, man. Yep, okay, good. Oh, anticipate is good. And I'm actually going to do this pre-combat just to see if I get something that I really need. Because I need something. That'll do it. Let's see, is that enough? If he double blocks? So let's say I go in for two. That's only six damage. But I might be able to take out his incubator drone, depending on how he drone. No, I will. No matter who he blocks, I can take out his incubator drone. Oh, God. All right. Do I do it? I mean, he's dead if he doesn't. I don't know. I really don't know. I have no idea. He is blocking here. That's fine. I'm happy to do this. I want to kill his incubator drone. And he'll be taking 7. So this could be game. Man, Inspired Charge is fucking winning me right now, man. I need that Inspired Charge so bad. Oh, God. If he has another removal, I'm gonna smash my fucking television, man. I'm gonna be so pissed off. Oh, man. All right, let's see. All right, he's taken 7. So he's down to 2. He's gonna lose this guy. I'm gonna keep all of my creatures. I'm still at 12. I don't know. He's thinking right now. He's thinking good. I mean, he knows I had to cast Anticipate to get this, so it's not really top decking. I mean, I don't know. You could say, oh, I top decked the Anticipate, but at that point, you can just say, you know, you're top decking literally everything. Exile target permanent, son of a bitch! Fucking A, man! And he's targeting this fucking creature here, so he keeps his blocker back. You asshole. God damn it. Fuck, man. Jesus. This guy took all the removal. God. All right, he's still going to 2. But now... Oh, God, I need to do 2 damage to this asshole. God damn it. We're both top decking. That's the good part. The bad part is that he's gonna shit out 3 fucking 1/1s because he just dropped this piece of shit. And that's at instant speed, too. Oh, God. Swing for 1. Go ahead. Unless you're scared. Alright, yeah. I mean, I hear you. You might as well. Jesus. Whoa. Oh, I know why he's doing that. Because he's got these guys coming in. He knows he has more blockers. I do need a flyer. A flyer would be great. The fucking courier griffin would be great. I don't think I can... I have another sky spawn. Shit. This son of a bitch is drawing just the most perfect fucking cards for this situation. I'm getting real mad here. I can't get through. I'm just going to lose a creature. Just gonna lose a fucking creature. I can gain 1 life. I'm gonna be losing 3. Unless he chooses to alpha strike. I can't believe this guy. This guy... Ugh. Son of a bitch, man. I'm actually really mad right now. This guy really fucking... Just had the right goddamn cards. Just had the right card. Like, there's nothing I can do. I think I'm playing perfectly. I don't think I did a single misplay in this entire game, and I'm still going to lose to this dickhead. Gain a life. Come on. And he's got the mana open to shit out those 3 1/1 scions. I need to do 2 damage to him. It's not going to do it. I can't swing in. This is what's going to happen if I swing in. This 2/3 is going to block this 2/2. He's going to chump the 2/3, shit out a couple more of these guys. He can either chump them all down, or he can kill 2 of them, and then I'll be stuck with a 1/3. Either way, he's doing 3 damage to me a turn. So I'm on a 4-turn clock. 3-turn clock. 3-turn clock. Excuse me. And he's at 2 goddamn life. No, I'm not. I'm at more than that. I'm at 4-turn clock because I can gain a life. As long as I have that, I'm okay. Do I have angelic, the thing that gives one of my guys flying? If I have that, I can win. Instant speed, or not instant speed. Oh God, that's my win condition right there. If I have a card in my deck, I'm just gonna do that now. Fine, you go ahead and do that now. Makes no difference to me. That's why I didn't swing in before, because you were just gonna fucking shit on me. I mean, I guess at this point he could even just swing in completely if he's really greedy. I don't think that's a good idea, but he could. Can't block any of this. Sorry, guys. I know I'm not talking right now. I'm really into this right now, and I'm so pissed. That fucking... This card right here. Scour from Existence. Perfect play. I do have a card that can get me out of here. That isn't it. It doesn't hurt. It'll keep me alive a little bit longer. But that is not the card I need. So he has 4, 5, 6. Yeah, he can wipe a lot of my field. I need a flyer. That's what has to happen right now. Oh man, this is a tough game, man. This guy's really picked incredible cards, and I know the worst part, honestly, is that I know that he's got this massive bomb on its way, and there's not a whole lot I can do about it. But I mean, that's the nature of top decking, right? Like, but I have one card that I need, and he's got like a bunch. That's the worst part. Gain a life. Go to 4. 2-turn clock. He can probably swing all in next turn. This has to be it. This is not it. Oh, God. Come on, you guys. Come on. Give me a break here. Real bad. Bad motherfucker right here. I'm so mad at this guy. Look at this. We're down to 6 minutes, so we've spent the whole time playing. I'm just gonna do this right now. Back to 3. Halimar, not bad. One, two, three. I don't think I have anything in my... No, I don't. No, I don't. I don't have shit. I don't know why he's trying to kill it. It doesn't do jack shit. Put 2 cards or... opponent's own from exile. That's fine. Dude, there's no need to do that. I don't have anything in my graveyard that I can recur. Like, these are the 3 cards I have. It's useless to do what he's doing. I know he's just scared. Oh, maybe he's just dropping a 2-3 flyer. I think that's game, you guys. I don't think he can get through this. So he's dealing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 damage to me. I just lost. Concede game. There's nothing I can do. There's really nothing I can do. Oh, I don't have the card. God damn it. There it is. Angelic Gift. Well, it's going in. It's going in right now. It is going in so I can play. I guess I'll drop a Stonehaven. I don't know. I don't really want to, actually. No, screw that. I'm taking my Stonehaven back. And I will drop... I don't want to lose any flyers. Flyers are really good right now. McKinney Patrol's possible. Actually, Felidar Cub isn't the best. No. Yeah, that's actually what I'm going to do. Okay, submit deck. Game three. Jesus Christ. This guy. I'm really letting that hit me. I'm really, really. I feel like I watched something, you know? Like, something should happen.